गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। आई एम प्रोफेसर सुभाष पिंगड़े फ्रॉम एस के एन सिंहगढ़ कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग कोटी पंडरपुर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द फाइल एक्सेस प्रोटोकॉल। इन द लास्ट सेशन वी हैव सीन द फाइल एक्सेस प्रोटोकॉल नेम एज FTP। इन टुडेज लेक्चर विल सी अबाउट द TFTP। FTP and TFTP, these are the two file access protocol. Already we have learned about the FTP. Now we'll learn about the TFTP. TFTP is nothing but the trivial file transfer protocol. Now before going to see the introduction and the content of the TFTP, let me tell you the basic difference between the FTP and TFTP. So FTP does a lots of functionality as compared to the TFTP. The main purpose of the TFTP is to just copy a small file from one host to the another host, or from one system to the another system. So at that time we can use the TFTP. Let me tell you the example. For example, suppose in a diskless workstation, BOOTP protocol which we are using, or suppose DHCP protocol is used to assign the IP addresses dynamically. So at that time it creates one a configuration file, BOOTP protocol or DHCP protocol. So such a small file, config file, that can be copied from router, switch, or from any other internet device to the system or computer. So at that time we can use the TFTP. So TFTP is used to copy, simply a copy small file from one host to the another host. That is the basic purpose of the TFTP. Now we'll see its different message format, its command processing, and its applications. So there are occasions TFTP, there are occasions when we need to simply a copy file without the need for all of the features of the FTP protocol. For example, when a diskless workstation or a router is booted, we need to download the bootstrap and configuration file. Here, we do not need all of the sophistication provided in FTP. So we just need a protocol that quickly copies the files. Means just we want to copy the file immediately, we can send it fastly. So at that time we can use the TFTP. Now what we have to discuss over here in the TFTP, we'll see. So these are the some points which we have to discuss in this session: messages, connections, data transfer, UDP ports, TFTP example, TFTP options, security, and applications. So these are the points which we have to study. So first of all, we'll see about the messages. So here TFTP uses the just I explained to you regarding the TFTP and its basic difference between the TFTP and FTP. FTP uses the port number 20 for data and 21 for control while establishing the connection. But here TFTP uses the services of UDP on the well-known port 69. Keep in mind. Okay, TFTP uses the services of UDP protocol. While FTP uses the services of TCP protocol. That is the major difference in the FTP and TFTP. TFTP can't use the TCP protocol. Okay, can't means we are not using. Okay, generally TFTP uses the services of UDP protocol, and that port number is 69. Okay, so now let me tell you the port number of all the protocols which we have studied. Telnet, which is having the port number 23, which already we have seen. Then FTP for data connection, it uses the 20. For control connection, it uses the 21. Then here TFTP uses the services of UDP on the port number 69. SMTP protocol, it uses the port number 25. Okay, five I am telling to you because on this point regarding the port number, the question may be asked in the MCQ, multiple choice question. So we'll see the message format or the message categories of the TFTP protocol. RRQ, WRQ, data, acknowledgement, error. RRQ is nothing but the read request, write request, data, acknowledgement, and errors. So we'll see one by one. These are the five format or inside the categories of the messages. It's when the TFTP transfer the messages at that time, these are the different categories. So we'll see one by one. First one is the RRQ categories. So this is the format of RRQ categories, which contain these different fields of code, file name, mode. So RRQ is the read request message is used by the client to establish a connection for reading data from the server. You can see in the figure. Okay, once again, I'm telling RRQ is the read request. RRQ stands for read request. Message is used by the client to establish a connection for reading data from the server, which is shown in the figure. So these are the different fields. So first one is the opcode. The size of this field is 2 byte. Opcode means operation code. The value is 1 for the RRQ message. Okay, read request means when the client is establishing the connection, at that time RRQ value will be set as a 1. Second field is the file name. This field is a variable size string encoded in ASCII format that define the name of the file. Since the file name varies in length, termination is signaled by one byte field of zeros. How it is terminated and how it will be indicated? One byte of all the zeros. Then third field, mode. That this field again variable size string defining the transfer mode. The mode field is terminated by another one byte field of zeros. The mode can be one of the two strings, that is NAT ASCII or octet. These are the two strings, NAT ASCII or octet. So the file name and mode fields can be in upper or lower case or combination of both. Okay, so these are the different fields of the RRQ message format. And now we'll see the next one. Write request. Write request message is used by the client to establish a connection for writing data to the server. We have seen read request message is used by the client to establish a connection for reading data from the server. Means what? Client is establishing the connection with the server, and whatever the data on the server is available, that data will be read. So at that time RRQ message format is used. But if you want to write some data on the server, at that time write request message format is used. So the format is same as like the RRQ. So here the difference is that operation code is 2. In case of the RRQ, operation code was 1. Otherwise all the remaining fields are same and the purpose is also same. Then so I am not explaining these things once again. Next one is the data format. So the data message is used by the client or the server to send blocks of data. Its format is shown over in this figure. Okay, to send blocks of data. So it consists of again these three fields, opcode, block number and data. So here opcode field is equal to 3. that is operation code. The first field is a 2-byte operation code. The value is 3 for the data message. Operation code value is equal to 1 for read request message. Operation code value is equal to 2 for write request message. And operation code value is equal to 3 for data field. Now next field is the block number. The size of the block number is 2 byte. Even the size of the operation code is also 2 byte. Block number, this is a 2-byte field containing the block number. The sender of the data, that is client or server, uses this field for sequencing. So all blocks are numbered sequentially starting with 1. The block number is necessary for acknowledgement as well for the acknowledgement, as we'll see later on in the acknowledgement format. Okay, so this is about the block number. And the last field is the data. The size of this field is from 0 to 512 bytes. So data message, except that the last block which must be between the 0 and 511, that is 512 bytes. A non-512 byte block is used as a signal that the sender has sent all the data. Sender has sent all the data. So here data can be transferred in either NVT or NVT ASCII. We have seen about the NVT ASCII or binary octet format. Okay, so this is all about the data format. Then next one is the acknowledgement field. Acknowledgement message is used by the client or server to acknowledge the receipt of a data block. The message is only 4 byte long. The format is shown in this figure. Operation code is equal to 4, the size is 2 byte, and block number is, again the size of the block number is 2 byte. Okay, here value is set of opcode as a 4. Block number size is 2 byte. So the acknowledgement message can also be a response to a write request message. It is sent by the server to indicate that it is ready to receive data from the client. So in this case, the value of the block number field is 0. Then we'll see the error message format. Error message format, these are the different fields. Opcode is equal to 5. Error number is equal to 2 bytes. Error data variable is, the size is variable. So we'll see that one by one. The error message is used by the client or the server when a connection cannot be established or when there is a problem during data transmission. It can be sent as a negative response to read request or write request. It can also be used if the next block cannot be transferred during the actual data transfer phase. So the error message is not used to declare a damaged or duplicated message. The problem resolved by error control mechanism. See the error message format. So we'll see the field. Operation code, size is 2 byte, the value is 5 for the error message. Keep in mind for everyone, read request, opcode value 1, write request, opcode value 2. Then we have seen the data, opcode value 3. Then we have seen the ACK, opcode value 4. And now error, opcode value 5. The next field is the error number. This 2-byte field define the type of error. Types of error. There are different types of the errors. Means suppose there is a 0, then not defined, 1, file not found, number. I am saying, talking about the numbers, error numbers. Means the value is suppose 3, then disk full. Suppose the value is 4, then illegal operation. Means this is a type of meaning of the errors. Suppose the value display 5, then unknown port number. Suppose it displays the value 6, then file already exists. Okay, so these are the different types of the error number. And the next one is the error data. Okay, error data. The variable byte field contains the textual error data and is terminated by one byte field of zeros. So these are the different fields of error format. These are the error numbers. Just I talk about this. The meaning: zero not defined, one file not found, two access solution, disk full, illegal operation 4, then 5 unknown port number. Okay, 6 number file already exist. Then next one is the connection establishment. As we have seen, TFTP uses the UDP protocol file transferring the message, and its port number is 69 because there is no provision for connection establishment and termination in UDP. We know that the difference between the TCP and UDP. UDP does not establish the connection. It just send the messages, just send the files. While TCP first of all establish the connection and then you transfer the data, messages or files. So UDP transfer, here UDP transfer each block of data encapsulated in an independent user datagram. All the packets travels in independent way in case of the UDP. In TFTP, we do not want to transfer only one block of data. We do not want to transfer the file as an independent block either. So we need connection for the block of data being transferred if they all being into the same file. So TFTP uses, just we have studied the different formats, that is RRQ, WRQ, ACK and error message to establish the connection. So it uses the data message with the in block of data. Because UDP does not use this, in case of the UDP, we are not establishing the connection. So what does here TFTP? TFTP use the above the different message format, and there are different fields and the meaning is there of each field. So we'll see that how the connection is established for reading the message or data in figure. See on the slide, in this figure, for reading, first of all, see about the reading. To establish a connection for reading, the TFTP client sends the RRQ message, because RRQ is used to establish the connection with the server, and that message is sent by the client. The name of the file and the transmission mode is defined in the message. If the server can transfer the file, it responds positively with the data message containing the first block of data. If there is a problem, such a different difficulty in opening the file or permission restriction or some other problem is there, then it is sent by the error message format about the reading. Now we'll see about the writing. To establish a connection for writing, the TFTP client uses the which message format? WRQ, that is the write request. The name of the file and the transmission mode is defined in the message. If the server can accept a copy of the file, it responds positively with the acknowledgement message using the value of 0 for the block number. If there is any problem, then server responds negatively by sending an error message. So this is about the connection establishment. Connection termination, it's very simple. Once the entire file is transferred, the connection must be terminated. So there is no such a special provision for the connection termination by using the TFTP protocol, or it does not use any message format. Now we'll see about the data transfer, because data transfer occurs the phase in between the connection establishment and connection termination. And here servers apatis bugs, this is the format. Okay, whenever the files are transferred from client to server, or suppose from server to client, at that time there is some maybe the flow control or error control this such a mechanism is required. So TFTP uses, or it can leads to the problem known as a server separatist bugs problem. In the diagram you can see here, the acknowledgement for the fifth block is delay. After the timeout expiration, the sender retransmit the fifth block, which will be acknowledged by the receiver again. So the sender receives two acknowledgments for the fifth block, which trigger it to send the sixth block twice. So the receiver receive the sixth block twice and again send two acknowledgments, which result in the sending the seventh block twice. Okay, you can see over here in this diagram, two times the acknowledgement is coming. So that is the problem while transferring the data. So here it uses the UDP port. When a process uses the services of UDP port, the server process issue a passive open as the well-known port and wait for the client process, which we know that the server is always ready to provide the services to the client. So first, so server, we can say in which state it is a passive open, but once the request comes from the client, then it establishes the connection with the client by issuing well-known port number, that is a 69. So you can see the figure. So in this figure, passive open by the server, the server passively open the connection using the well-known port number 69. Then in the second step, you can see client actively open a connection using an ephemeral port number, even though same thing we have seen in case of the FTP also. Ephemeral port number for the source port, and server is respond to that request by using the well-known port number of UDP, that is 69. And then this is called as the active open by the client. And how the remaining communication takes place, server actively open a connection using a new ephemeral port for the source port and use the ephemeral port received from the clients at the destination port. So it sends the data and the acknowledgement, and the remaining data will be transferred. So which is shown here in figure C, rest of communication. TFTP example. See the diagram. There are the different steps are there in between the client and server. Okay, just I will explain within 2 minutes. The client want to retrieve a copy of the content. Suppose when that size of that file is suppose 2000 byte, name as a file one, okay, which is shown in the message file one. The client sends the read required message. The server sends the first block carrying the first 512 byte, which is received and acknowledge. These two messages are the connection establishment. Then the second block carrying the second 512 byte is lost. So after the timeout, the server retransmit the block which is received. The third block carrying the third 512 byte is received, but the acknowledgement is lost. So after the timeout, the receiver retransmit the acknowledgement. The last block carrying the remaining data, that is a 464 byte, which is shown in the figure, and is received and is received. Okay, so the client simply received, or suppose if it is damaged, then the client simply it discard. After the timeout, server retransmit the block, and this message is considered the connection termination because the block carries fewer than 512 byte. Because the size, in between the client and server, when the communication takes place, we have seen RRQ, WRQ, error, data, ACK, these are the different message format is used, and the size of the data block is 512 byte. So what, suppose there are in this figure, the size of the file is given, that is 2000 byte. So 512, 512, 512 bytes are transferred from server to the client. But once the how it recognizes it is a last block, so it is recognized by what's the remaining size of the data. So it is less, if it is less than 512 byte, then it client assume that yes, it is the last block of the data, and it terminate the connection. So this is the way application of TFTP. As I told you, TFTP is very useful for the basic file transfer where security is not used. Okay, here let me tell you one more difference. FTP is more secure than the TFTP. Okay, in the TFTP there is no provision to provide the security. So we can say that this is a second major difference between the FTP and TFTP. So it can be now where it is used, this TFTP. TFTP is used to initialize device such as bridge or router. Its main application is in conjunction with the PuTTP or DHCP protocol. TFTP requires only a small amount of memory and use only the services of UDP and IP. IP is also connectionless and unreliable. That's why it is called as the best effort delivery service. Okay, connectionless and unreliable, as like the UDP. So it can easily be configured in the ROM. When the station is powered on, TFTP will be connected to the server and can download the configuration file from there. Okay, so you can see here in this figure. Okay, 1, 2. And DHCP client send the request to the DHCP server, and server gives reply to the client. Then here TFTP client sends the request to the TFTP server, and TFTP server gives back reply to the TFTP client. So here client can easily download the configuration file, which is stored into the ROM of router, or we can say any internet working device, switch. Okay, the size of this file is very less. DHCP configuration file from the PuTTP server. The station then appears the name of the file or the top file to the TFTP client to get the content file from the TFTP server.